Hello everyone, this is Pastor Carvel Richards and we are at day number 17 of our 31 days of intercessory prayer. Today, let us pray for those in authority, government, all of them, all those in authority. Listen to what the Apostle Paul says in 1 Timothy chapter 2 verses 1 and 2. First of all then, I urge that entreaties and prayers, petition and thanksgiving be made on behalf of all men, for kings and all who are in authority, so that we may lead a tranquil and quiet life in all godliness and dignity. When this text was written, the Roman power was the one that was in charge. And it's as though Paul was writing to let this congregation, this audience know that, listen, your prayers can make a difference. Your prayers can make a difference in how the government operate. And it is our duty to lift them up in prayers. Too often we criticize them. But as we have established from the beginning that there are many things God would want to do. But unless we pray for those in authorities to yield themselves to the Spirit of God, not much ethical things will take place. Not much godliness on their part will take place when it comes to decision making for the welfare and the well-being of the country and of the land. So let us pray for them. Let us pray for the Prime Minister. Let us pray for the Cabinet. Let us pray for all of them, beloved friends, for them to yield themselves to the Spirit of God. How will we pray for this? Let me tell you how we will pray for this. As a sweet-smelling offering to God. Revelation chapter 8 verses 3 and 5. Revelation chapter 8 verses 3 and 5 says, another angel came and stood at the altar holding a golden censer, and much incense was given to him so that he might add it to the prayers of the saints on the golden altar which was before the throne. And the smoke of the incense with the prayers of the saints went up before God out of the angel's hand. Then the angel took the censer and filled it with the fire of the altar and threw it on the earth. And there followed peals of thunder and sounds of and flashings of lightning and earthquake. So not only is our prayers a sweet-smelling offering to God, but our prayers are powerful and they effect change on earth. So God wants to work through your prayers and mine, beloved friends. This is what Andrew Murray said. We need to take our prayer time as seriously as God takes it. We need to take our prayer time seriously as God takes it. Let us pray for those who are in authority. Let us pray.